if he is traveling, he is going home now. He's in a journey and he's going home. So he prays Maghrib on the way. Is he allowed to pray Isha, Jam'a, combine Isha with Maghrib? And in this case, he will pray Isha Qasr, of course, 2 rak'ahs. Even though he knows that he might reach home before midnight, yes, it is permissible. Because you are still on a journey and you never know whether you will make it on time or not. So that is permissible. And when you reach home, you do not owe the Isha prayer again. You don't have to make it up again because you already prayed it since you were traveling. One more thing as an expansion to the answer of this question, which is, what if the Adhan of Isha has been called or its time has entered when I was in my town and I reached before midnight, I had not prayed Isha yet. Do I pray 2 rak'ahs uli qasr since I'm making up a prayer which I had or I owed when I was traveling, or I pray it on fall? You've arrived to your destination or to your hometown where your wife and kids are living with you. In this case, you must pray it on full. Even though its time has entered upon you when you were traveling. Since you did not pray it while traveling, when you come back, you pray it full. When somebody is confused about, I'm going to my parents' house, shall I show them my prayer or not? Am I having this concession or not? We say, you show in your prayer to any city that you travel in, the travel distance, where you don't have your own house and wife living in. So if somebody is having more than one wife, and they're far away from each other, not to make them fight, he put everyone in a distance from the other. And now he travels, even if he travels every day, the travel distance. But he has a wife here and a wife there. His wife and kids, that's his house. So he is not eligible to shorten the prayer. The catch or the effective cause of shortening the prayer is traveling. And I'm considered to be traveling if I don't have a house and a family in the city.